to another episode of Hey Alexia, What's Trending? Over the past year, people have been trying to come up with ways to cope with the state of our world. Like if you watched my last video, chess has become a really popular way to cope with the lack of social interaction. And as I've been scrolling through my TikTok, I couldn't help but notice another very aesthetically pleasing way of coping. And that would be crystals. Crystal healing has become so popular that there's even a side of TikTok called Crystal TikTok that's specifically dedicated to this trend. There's tons of videos talking about crystals for beginners, spotting real and fake crystals, or people just showing off their collection. This trend is so aesthetically pleasing, so you know I have to jump on it. This is quartz, promotes forgiveness and self-acceptance, brings peacefulness and love to relationships, and a very good stone for family and friendship. I think that this is a good one to get during the pandemic because you're stuck with your family, you know, and you need all the love that you can get so you don't get annoyed by them. I've seen before that like you can like transmit energy through like two of these. You put one facing into you like this and then facing out. This is amethyst. This one is really cool. Like look how pretty that is. Apparently, it's supposed to like increase the vividity. I don't know. It's supposed to make your dreams more vivid. Even if it doesn't work, it's still cool. Like look how they're so pretty. I decided to investigate further into this trend to see if there's any scientific evidence behind crystal healing or if it's just a placebo effect, and if we can draw any parallels between modern science and crystal healing. Do you know kind of where crystal healing or the idea of crystal healing originated from?
Well, the earliest mention that we have of people using crystals for their magical abilities is from ancient times. And we're talking as far back as 4500 BC with ancient Sumerians using them in their magical formulas. And in terms of crystal healing, we have stories about this from ancient Egypt around 3000 BC, where Egyptians would use them for both the living and the dead for protection and health. So for example, they would decorate themselves and their mummies with amulets, which are these small pieces of jewelry like rings or necklaces that people think protect them from danger or disease. So when we think about the modern philosophy of crystal healing, we think it comes from the Buddhist or Hindu ideas of chakras and the Chinese concept of qi, which have to do with channeling and changing your body centers of life energy. And so today, people across the world, from the UK to India to Native Americans in the US, use crystals as part of their spiritual and traditional practices.
You mentioned chakras, and I know that there's like all kinds of different chakras, like the crown chakra, heart chakra. How does that kind of tie in with now modern medicine and modern science?
You know, we understand that different people have different ideas, but the concept of chakras doesn't really fit well in that model. And so in terms of actual science behind crystals and how they might influence these chakras, I wish there was evidence, but unfortunately there isn't really any verified science that proves that crystals themselves help with pain or illness. So, I mean, I'm a doctor and I have a degree in human biology. In order to recommend something to my patients, it has to have a certain amount of evidence and research behind it. And as far as I know, there aren't really any well-designed scientific studies showing that crystals have these special healing properties. You know, you or other people who are watching this might be thinking, but when I do hold or when I do wear or focus on my crystals, I feel better and I feel like it does help. And a lot of scientists actually think that this feeling comes down to the placebo effect, which is the positive effect that you get from a drug or a treatment that have nothing to do with the thing itself. And it's really based on our expectations. So if you believe that something will happen, that influences what you notice or feel as a result of exposing yourself to it. And in some cases, this placebo effect can be just or almost as strong as the effect of a real medication. The only study I know about crystals, like in terms of a scientific study, that was presented by Dr. Christopher French in the UK in 2001. Basically, they gave 80 volunteers either a quartz crystal or a fake crystal, and they asked them to sit and meditate for 5 minutes with it. And it didn't matter if they had a real one or a fake one. 74 out of the 80 people reported that they did feel the buzz and the tingle that they were told to expect. And not only that, but people who already believed in the power of crystals were twice as likely to say that they felt an effect even though they were holding a fake crystal. So because they believed it, they felt it. And I mean, you know, this is the current basis of scientific evidence. If some well-designed studies get published in the future, I would be totally happy to change my mind about this.
You said that there aren't any scientifically proven physical effects, but what about the mental effects that crystals can have on people?
Well, the short answer is there isn't really much evidence showing that crystals can improve mental health either. But I have to say that the rituals and practices that often surround crystal healing, like meditation or mindfulness or positive thinking, have been shown to improve your mental health and even physical health. And also because crystal healing has become so trendy, there's this pretty big community of people out there who believe in the healing powers of crystal and the earth. And feeling connected to other people, which is especially important right now, can create this sense of belonging and well-being. And also, crystals are beautiful. Like, I have these really cool crystals here, you know, that my son smashed open with a hammer from a geode, and it makes me smile whenever I look at it. And so, just like other beautiful things like art or flowers, crystals can make us happier just by looking at them. If holding or wearing a crystal makes you feel better, there's no harm in it. You can keep doing it. I just don't want people to avoid other forms of healing and medicine with proven evidence if they do have a serious medical condition.
What are some other natural things or natural remedies that are like scientifically proven to work?
I'm so glad you asked that question, because there is a more natural kind of medicine that helps with all kinds of medical conditions, and that medicine is nature. I'm actually the director of PARX, which is Canada's first national science-based nature prescription program, where doctors, nurses, and other healthcare professionals across Canada are actually prescribing doses of nature to their patients to improve their health. A lot of people have this intuitive sense that when they head outside, they feel better. But there's a huge amount of science to actually back that up. So, for example, nature is so powerful that just looking at pictures of nature on your walls or having plants inside your home can improve your mental health. There was a study that showed that patients who had surgery at the same hospital who looked out at nature out their window instead of a brick wall actually used less pain medication and bothered their nurses less often. And research also shows, in terms of kids, that kids who spend time outside in nature develop better eyesight, they sleep better, they focus better, and they have less anxiety and depression. If you're looking for something natural to boost your health with a ton of evidence behind it, spend time in nature.
I hope that you have found a healthy way of coping that you like and that brings you wellness, whether that's collecting crystals, playing chess, baking, or even binge-watching every Harry Potter movie over and over again. For CBC Kids News, I'm Alexia Sabau. I'll see you next time.